Hello friends, today I'm going to show you how to configure backups which are part of the Always On. For example, if we failover, that backup jobs automatically have to run based on the backup preferences. I will show you how to do that. Before going to do that, I would like to remember what the supported type it is. Here, if you see that if it is a primary replica, it will run the copy backup. If it is a secondary replica, it would be run with the copy only an option. Either it would be a synchronous or asynchronous. The log backup will be run on the primary replica, and you can also take that log backup, but without copy only. And the coming to differential, it will take we can take differential on the primary replica, but we cannot take differential on the secondary replica. And how to do that? So I have configured two node cluster, which is node 1 and node 2. Currently, just open that Always On. Alt replica. Node 1 is primary and node 2 is secondary. Okay, and let's see that the properties as well. Backup preferences. Now I want to run on the secondary only, but I don't want to go this. Why? Because we cannot run the differential backups. So what I need to do here is the primary. I want to run on the primary. All the backup should be run on the primary. If it is secondary replica, the backup should not get failed. Otherwise, we will get alert. Unnecessarily, we need to log in and see, log into the server and make sure that these are all secondary. That's the reason we cannot take that backup. So we don't need all these kind of stuff. That job automatically has to do that. Okay, and click on primary. Okay, and I told you, right, in the secondary there is no differential backup. So I will show the logic as well. Okay, currently the backup should run on the primary. If that replica is the primary, then only it will run, and otherwise it cannot run, but it has to show the logic. I mean, it should not get failed. Why? Because that it has to check that preferred replica is or not. So just go to the new query. Come on, go to the Whole and Grain and download that script. Open VMware Workstation and place that. Now I have dedicated a database for this. So DB I have created, and where I need to keep this, and just go to the C drive, right click on that properties, the shared path. So I'm copying the shared path, press OK. Here, place this in single inverted quotations. Cleanup time is 6 hours. Output directory also is I'm same log. Okay, so now I'm executing this. Output file directory. Oh, sorry, output file directory. I need to miss the quotations, right? Okay, execute. Now copy this and go to node 2. New query and make sure the database DBA is got created. Yeah, got created. Okay, so you already know that the there is like what I need to say. Backup should run on the primary. Okay, so go and refresh. Go on refresh, database is there, full on there, steps, select, click on that. So now I want to do the backup of availability databases only, not for everyone. So what I need to do, click on server backups, Now I want to copy this command. And replace with the data, user databases. Click OK. Click OK. Now do the same for this thing as well. Click Edit. Now log backup. Okay, so now we need to do the same in the node 2 as well. Go to full backup, user databases, click on steps, edit. Now replace this, click OK. Do the same for differential. Okay, I have configured everything. Let's see that. Okay, this is the primary. Now what I'm going to run the full backup. Okay, and click start. Yeah, it's got success. So only one file has to get created. Say one file got created. Now I'm going to run the full backup job in the secondary as well. Let's see that. Either it could be success or not. Either it got success, but that file should not get created. Let's see that whether it is created or not. Is that got created? No. Why? Because we have selected the backup references in the to run on the only primary replica. Now what I'm going to do here is I'm going to change the backup references. See, even though the backup file is not get created, but it got success. The reason is it is not a free replica. So if it is not free replica, it should not go for the second step. Okay, and now what I am doing, I want to run with the node 2 only. At that time, if you want to do that, you need to fail over to the secondary. So now I will fail over. Click on add failover and next finish. Okay, now if you run this job, agent job, okay, it will not get created. Let's do that. It got success, but see, still there is only one file. I will show you here. Right click on that, view history. Okay, two jobs got created. Now I am running in the secondary. Now it has to get created. Okay, see, got created. Now what I'm doing here is I'm doing another experiment. Right click on that, properties. Now I'm changing the backup reference to run on the secondary. Okay, you know all that. The second, the secondary databases, it is going to run with a copy only. Okay, so now I am running that, the full backup job. Okay, let's see that is it got created or not. It's got created, third one. Okay. It is going to create differential. Let's see that it is going to create differential or not. Yes. Why? Because it is a primary one. In the primary, we can take the differential backups. See, if you see this, go that. See, differential backup got created. And if you go to node 1, okay, node 1 is currently secondary. Okay, now go to that differential. I'm running this. See, have we still or not? No, it got not executed still yet. So, running job got executed, but either its file got created or not. Let's see that. Totally, we have two differences. But actually we have one. It means the job got success, but the based on the backup references, the differential backup should not we cannot backup differential backup and secondary replica. Currently that node one is acting as a secondary replica, and by these jobs we cannot even though if got run it will get success, but it will not show as a failure, and based on that you will not get any alerts that this database got failed because of it is in read only. Okay, and if you see, go to the node 2, I am running the differential. Okay, now totally the bag differential bag file should be two. I need two differentials. Two differentials. Now I'm going to take the log backup on the primary. On the node 2, I am taking that. It got created. Why? Because we can take log backup on the primary and the secondary as well. Oh, sorry, the log file didn't get created. And the node 1, okay, maybe. So what I'm doing, why? Because the log backup should run on only on the, we have given the preference as secondary, right? So that's the reason it is not running on the primary. Now what I'm doing here, I'm just going there, this is secondary, currently acting as a secondary, just check that. And now it is secondary, node 1 is secondary. Now log backup, now the file will get created. Say file got created. Again, if you run at the primary also we can take, but the backup preferences should change to any replica. At that time only that log backup can be taken. All these jobs comes without schedules. You need to configure based on your requirement. For example, where there is a database with a highly transactions. So at that time, you need to configure the log backup for every 15 minutes. And it daily grows or like 100 GB, the whole database. So daily taking 100 GB of data, full backup and keeping for up to 2 weeks is not a good recommendation. It costs the storage. So weekly I want to configure differential full backup, a daily differential, or for every 15 minutes or half an hour, or based on the transaction flow and how frequency the log file getting full. So based on these all these conditions, you need to schedule your timings like this for the full backup and log backup and differential backup as well. Okay, so this is how you need to work with always on backups. I hope you like this video. If you have any doubts, just comment it out and I will answer after some time. Okay, and the backup Holy Grail chips are completely free, and you don't require any link to be given in the description box. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you. Bye.